morning and welcome. The priest's intentions for this morning's Mass are for our parish community. Please remember to silence your cell phones. Thank you.
Good morning, and welcome to Our Lady of Light Catholic Community. As we gather together on this 4th of July weekend, let us rejoice in the freedom Jesus offered us from our heavenly burdens. Please stand.
What I have failed to do. Through my fault, whom I know to be in his fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. O God, who in the basement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, Rejoice heartily, O daughter of Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter of Jerusalem. See, your king shall come out to you, a just savior is he, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion will be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will extol you, O my God and King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. I will raise your name forever, my King. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate towards all his works. I will praise your name forever, the King of the God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. I will praise your name forevermore. The Lord is faithful in all his works and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling, and raises up those who are bowed down.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. if the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. Notice how the Lord is speaking. Not to the wise, but to the learned who feel they know everything. But he's speaking to us in humility, speaking to the community in Rome. He reminded them that when we are in our flesh and hurt as many, we miss that spiritual part of ourselves that call us to be that childlike. We are the ones at times that make life very, very, very complicated. The Lord is reminding all of us that it is very simple. That we come to Him. That spiritual side of us, we must continue to nourish. Just as we nourish that fleshly and corporeal side of ourselves. And that's why we gather each week, to continue to give praise to the Father. Because at times we forget that the Lord is there in our midst. Because we get hung up and we get distracted so many, many, many things. And we forget to take that moment to step back from that situation and allow the presence of the Lord to come in to our lives. He says there, come to me, all you who feel labor and burden. Come and seek me out. Take upon you my yoke, which is easy, and my burden, which is light. Allow me to walk with you in your daily lives. How often do we allow ourselves that openness to the Father walking hand in hand? And guiding us. As even the prophet Zechariah today calls all of those to rejoice heartily and shout for joy. Rejoice that we have this Lord present in our lives. That we come to him with our burdens and our wants. And we lay those burdens and our wants at the feet of the Lord. That through this meal, through his Eucharist, that spiritual side of ourselves may be nourished and may come to completion and bring the completion inside ourselves, that the Lord will guide our feet into the ways of his peace. So today, let us take some time to relax in the presence of the Lord. And allow the Lord to reveal himself more deeply to us. As a father unfolds a life for a son, may the Lord today unfold for us his life within us. That we can bring to completion the work that the Lord begins in all of us. May God bless. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God and light from light, the true God from true God, begotten, not made, not substantial but the Father, through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And let us come before God with our needs and our burdens, and we promise that they will be lightened.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Christians around the world who are suffering from persecution, that they may be kept safe from harm, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That peace may be proclaimed in our country, both within and without, as we celebrate the anniversary of our independence this 4th of July weekend. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who experience violence in their daily lives, that our prayers may guide them away from hopelessness and toward healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord Jesus, who healed the sick and gave them new life, be the doctors, nurses, and all healthcare workers as they act as agents of your healing touch. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Paul Culver, Hadley Ray Strimboo, and Teresa Charles Sharman, may they have eternal life with God in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of believers, that the unspoken prayers in our hearts and the prayers written in our book of intercessions may be lifted up to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Our King and our God, you are gracious and merciful, good to all and compassionate toward all you have created. Listen to the prayers we make and lighten our burdens. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation, dedicated to your name, purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess a pledge of life eternal. For I have received the first fruits of the Spirit, whom you raised up, Jesus, from the dead. We hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, and in joyful celebration, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And much more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you who drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. A mystery of faith.
We proclaim you faithful, Lord, and confess the resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial, the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by his body and blood and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Francis de Sales and Jean de Chantel, and all your saints in whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Frank, our bishop, all the bishops of the clergy, the entire people you have deemed for your own. And listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at your passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously give us peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And my brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. And let us acknowledge one another with a weighty of peace. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God, but who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Thank you.
of us who are joining us live stream this morning will pray our prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are really present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you to come into my soul. Though I cannot now receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, and I myself hold it to you. Amen. And let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. And the Almighty God bless each and every one of us today and always, as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord. Let's all have a beautiful day, everybody.